Hey guys, today I'll be showing you how to install the new exploit called Notehax that got released for Flipnote Studio 3D. If you don't have this, you can download it from my Nintendo. It costs 200 platinum points, which isn't that difficult to get. I got mine just by linking an account and downloading Super Mario Run. So once you've got Flipnote Studio 3D downloaded onto your console, then you can eject your SD card from it and put it into your PC. So now you want to download and extract the Notehax archive to your SD card. I'll have all download links in the video description below, so go check that out and get the links. Now copy the file specific to your region on your 3DS's SD card like this. So once you've got all of those files copied, you need to get the Homebrew Launcher and an other app payload. So go to this website, again I'll have it linked in the video description below. Click Download Homebrew Starter Kit, then scroll down and find Other App Payloads. Enter your console information in the boxes. If you don't know this, then you can find it in System Settings on the top screen. So then click Download Other App. And then once you've got those two things downloaded, you want to rename the Other App payload to otherapp.bin. For me, the extension doesn't show up because I have a default program to open .bin files with, but for you, the .bin extension may show up. So once it's renamed to otherapp.bin, copy it to the Notehax folder on your 3DS's SD card. Now go back into your downloads and extract the Homebrew Launcher. Copy the files to 3DS's SD card like this. If it asks you to replace files, just click yes. So with that, you have all of the files ready and we can actually get on to launching the exploit. So right click on your 3DS's SD card and click eject, and then remove it from your PC and put it back into your console. And then turn on your console and I'll meet you there. So now you want to launch Flipnote Studio 3D. Once it loads up, click the View button and then click on the icon that says the Homebrew Launcher. This should load you into the Homebrew Launcher and then from there you'll have full access to it. So you can do anything that you can normally do in the Homebrew Launcher, like test out emulators, play games, and install themes and stuff. So yeah, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Leave a like if this helped you. Comment if you need help or if you want to help anyone else out. And subscribe for more videos like this in the future. And I'll see you next time.